and we enjoy a view into Watering Comics, which is one of the most beautiful interior inside of Hong Kong U right now. Alright, so let's get ready for the next wave of talks. Alright, now let's welcome our next speaker, Dr. Gary Young, to give a talk. INESA stack, a Smart City CoT OS. So Dr. Young received a bachelor degree in electrical engineering at National Taiwan University in 1987 and a Ph.D. degree in electrical engineering in the University of Southern California in 1995. So he's the executive vice president of IRDC, INESA R&D Center, also the technical director of INESA Electronics Group Corporation Limited, Shanghai in China. He serves on the board of SAIWAY Cloud Technology Limited, also a member of China Internet of Things Education Expert Committee. His industry experience and research areas are mainly focusing on service-oriented system design and optimization, such as Smart City. His current Smart City research works include system solutions on food safety, security surveillance service, intelligence lighting, vehicular area network, and remote medical or education systems. Now, let's welcome Dr. Young.
It would be nice if I can get a cup of water. Thank you. All right, so my talk today is INESA R&D, the Smart City CoT OS. It's a cloud of things operating system. It has been quite a pleasure that the article was selected, was chosen, and also re-invited to the Hong Kong SAR. And the AICT, Advanced Information and Communication Technology, would be the first INESA's international conference presentation. And we so appreciate this opportunity for this presence. And I think this is actually the best place for the presence. So I would like to talk about INESA because INESA is kind of new player in the industry. And so I introduced the company a little bit. And so that later on, we know what is the company's goal and strategy plan, and how what is this kind of, the kind of R&D that we really need.
Sorry, we're not a water. I can only give orange juice.
Thank you very much. So INESA is actually not a new player. INESA Holding has been a company in China for over 50 years, so more than half a century. And 50 years ago, more than 50% of the China electronic markets is actually occupied by INESA. So it's the top time, the best time of INESA, we have 250,000 people, and we have 50% and to 60% of TV and radio, that kind of electronic, consumer electronic markets. Even at this time, we still have 50,000 people. And the IRDC is INESA R&D Center, and we are under the INESA holding company and as a research arm, and having an umbrella as an umbrella for about 4,000 R&D people. And our main research here is actually looking at the major trends from our current technology and to combine them all together, which is the IoT, Internet of Things, and the cloud computing. And we're providing the smart city service. And there are real business service actually landscapes in Shanghai City, including like security, food tracing, food safety, intelligent lighting, and vehicular area network, the energy management, remote education, all that stuff. So IRDC is actually trying to heading the technology transform from the current industry position to the next level. Okay, that's a goal, and that's what we're doing. So we start from the industry, we start from the smart city operating system, because all those industry chains that I just introduced is under the purview of a smart city service. And we look at what the smart city has been proposed by IBM for a long time, and whose major audience are governments. But so far, there's no real way that it can realize this small city service in a sustainable and a lucrative way. So the company looking at analyze the problem and figure out there are four factors to enable a small city service. Number one is the government support. We need policy, we need authentications, we need the government to enable us to do the service. That's number one factor. Number two, where is the smart city machine? You know, I'm doing this PPT here. It's an application running on this PC, which is the machine, to support the service. But where is the machine that supports smart city service, which has been left up in the air and answered by the IBM press? And the smart city has CPU, has memory, they need elastic computing in the storage, and also the peripheral management. And those are actually based in IDC, the data center, which we have one, which INESA have one, and we're qualified to support, to own, and to operate the smart city machine. And also the peripherals, because you need end-to-end service. By the end of the day, the service delivered to a human being, and we need an end device, which is Internet of Things domain. And so we need a real business landscape. Like I mentioned before, there's several industry trends, like security, like lighting, surrounding our lives 7x24. And that's our daily life, and that's our real business. So we have the back end, the machine, and we have the peripherals. And what is missing here? The very last missing critical factor is the smart city OS. And we call it INESA OS, which is the iStack. So as that filled the gap to glue our brain and our fingertips, which are the IoT, the Internet of Things, all together intelligently, with the intelligent, properly distributed governance to provide a service. That's what is this, the smart city service has to start with this kind of platform. So if we talk about a way to develop an OS, and we'll talk about one kind of research we really need here to support this vision, that I'm glad to be here to share this vision, that's a vision with you guys, and we're hoping actually to have collaborations in the research area with the most intelligent people in this world, and we'll work together to find out what is the root cause that a smart city is not able to realize to prevent at this time, and we make it happen. So you look at general OS, everyone knows that we have CPU storage on the very bottom line, those are hardware peripherals. And we use the same analogy to look at the smart city OS. COT stands for the cloud of things. Basically, it's a cloud to manage things. It's head and end. So how do we combine the fingertips and we provide intelligence to work together to provide service in the city? You look at a very bottom layer, and we need resource management. You know, Professor Zhang talked about allocation, resource allocation, that's part of the resource management. And in a data center scale, it's actually the flexible, elastic computation and your infinite storage and also your big data analysis. All that stuff will be laid on this operating system. So it's more than OpenStack. OpenStack is a commonly used cloud operating, cloud resource management system. That's the cloud OS. But we're talking about operating system for the whole city, which means based on the cloud management, we can manage more than that. Which means on the front end, we look at the peripherals. For example, there are a lot of the projectors or the cameras. Consider those smart city equipments on certain corner. Once you turn it on, it will automatically plug and play into your OS, just like my USB. My USB drive, you plug in, you'll be found automatically. And not only that, the purpose to provide service, the reason that the smart city actually become a fancy idea and a revenue model become consulting fee, no more than that, is because there's no way to help people to realize that this is a model in a very efficient way. So you plug in a device, which is good. I found it like a USB device. And I recognize in a geographic location, even in a building like the third floor, using the beam, the building information model, I can recognize where this device are, just like where my fingers are, right? So I can start planning what kind of service I can do with those fingertips and with my brain. But the thing is, in a big data time, the major problem is too many information. When the fingertips goes off, and business relations actually grows exponential. And there's some intuitive way we create business, that's fine, we can do that. But the value of big data is that all those business value and new business models, they always incubated and created in a way that people don't realize it, and in different vertical markets who have to crossly analyzing and also to integrate all together. We need a platform. We need a platform to do that. So iStack actually is a platform, smart city operating system, to enable smart city service, which make things easier. So we should do some example to explain what I've been talking here. Okay, this is what I talk about, plug and play, in the very bottom layer. In the middle layer, we use OpenStack to cloud operating management, the resource management. And the other layer, I want to emphasize on this layer, this one, it's called auxiliary cross-functional service layer, which means to help people to generate business model to provide service. It serves enabled. And that will make smart city service sustainable, because you can't really depend on government. Otherwise, you become a bottleneck at a certain point, and it becomes silos everywhere. You can't integrate at all. You look at your search, you use Google, you search a keyword, you come back with 1,000 links. What are you going to do? Top three, that's our policy, right? That's the only thing we can do. Same thing here, when data was collected, accumulated exponentially, we need a systematic way to see how the business can be generated, how to use them effectively. So the OS has another layer, co-optionary cross-function service layer. And it provides support, we go further down here, is the business, the real business, the SaaS, S-A-A-S. They're running on top of different paths and eyes, the same paths and eyes, different SaaS running the same platform, and with the support of business to help people to be able to develop their SaaS. So what I'm saying here, I'll skip this, is let's just use a scenario. We minimize a smart city to be a smart building. So we look at in a smart building, how many sensors we can have camera, light or lighting gateway, and your temperature sensor, something like that. So that would be considered a smart city over there. Now I have all the sensors geographically distributed and plugged in place of my OS node. Okay. In my data center, my brand knows what I have there. How do I enable a service? Okay. So first of all, you have to see what kind of service, what are your business target? You have to select. So okay, those are the points I plan to provide my service in a smart city or in a smart building. And they have their natures. This is this company, provide this nature, this data, all that's all together. So we have to recognize them, we have to be able to, like a driver, you write a driver device, it tells you what it can do, what it cannot do, and what is provided. And those data will be sent out to your data center, your brain, to be analyzed. And those data have very complex data relationships, usually. And that's a problem we try to reduce the complexity and the result. That's needed, that's how that we're looking for. For small, for simple cases, for example, we probably don't go that far, going to map reduce and reduce the dimensionality, this and that. In single cases, like this. Okay, we have this building and a lot of windows, and we say, okay, those windows, and we have lighting systems, we can control the light there. Why don't we use the light to become an advertising machine? That's business idea. It's not too hard, right? So that's something that we can do with our brain to control those lights. You want to do advertising, do it. You want to send a greeting to your girlfriend, showing the big building, or sending a brief message to my wife, say, okay, I love you. There's a road in there, they write their name, romantic, and their business model, right? That's easy, that's heuristic. You can invent it. Or I can go further. I say, okay, you know what? I have other sensors. They're all in my control. I recognize them in a plug and play way. And I actually wanted to, I like this building, talk to outside, talk to people when there is a surveillance breach. For example, okay, this is a camera. Okay, if I find something actually in that window, somebody that I don't recognize, then actually I can turn this window to be red. That's another business application. Okay. So those are the engineering thing. We're not go that far, we're not in the R&D yet. We don't need that at the top range like you guys do that. Engineer can do that. Okay. We can heuristically think about this model. No problem, we do that. That's not somebody paying the money, we do this. Or at home, consider this is a home, this is a building. And my camera captures somebody outside at 3 o'clock in the morning. That's abnormal. That's easy. We have Agrin do that already. Other market. And what it's going to do, because we got the fingertip control by the gland, we say, okay, now the TV is also my fingertip. So when the signal 3 o'clock, something intrusion happened there, I can turn on the TV, steering away. That's one service I can do. Or, well, you know what? During my internal camera, I analyze there is a grandma at home. Don't wake him up to avoid a heart attack, right? There are a lot of intelligence we can play, but that's in the heuristic area. This is so reasonable. Whoever would like to propose and can make a business model, they can make money from there, they can do it. We can support. It's not a big deal. It's not a research problem at all. But there are research problems. If we talk about smart suit, and we talk about multiple hands, thousands and thousands of times, and millions of fingers, they're all together, collectively, how do we use it all together and to provide the right, not business model yet, to provide the right thinking, suggestions, like an expert system, to let the people incubate the idea to provide service. That's how the smart system can be sustainable. Because the party, different party, business party get it, they can make money. And they work to collaborate with the government. So government provides such a platform to incubate, to collaborate, to with more people, they can make money, and they invest. So for example, now we have this Shanghai map here, and how many sensors we have here? We can have like, there's wireless things, and there are gas sensor cameras, there are noise sensor, parking sensor, there's sensor everywhere. And the business model, actually, in the big data time, the best business is generated, actually, in the cross, in the vertical, cross-vertical data. That's something that you can't use a heuristic guess to know it. But we need some learning. In this model, for example, okay, so when a camera captures somebody in Huaihai Lu, because somewhere, this guy is called, in Shanghai, we call it Yangzhao, which means called taxi. You can recognize this by the big data analysis. Your camera captured this, your camera can see sitting on the street light. You capture this move, and you identify this as a taxi calling gesture. And this going through machine learning as well, because you might make mistakes. Somebody might just throw away a cigarette. So you have the learning. That's a kind of a big data service we have. In operating systems, we just have a service module, the big data learning, the high data, all that stuff. We provide such a training, sitting by 24, you learn very accurate gesture recognition to say, okay, this is how you raise your hand, you need a taxi. And also at the same time, the other cameras, they capture the empty cars. In Shanghai, the empty cars are green lights. So you capture green lights car, there are different zones, and those are people, they're waiting car, they're waiting, looking for cars, supply and demand. You pack it all together, you sell to the taxi company. Okay, so they provide, they do the best schedule. The professor didn't mention about schedule, right? The resource schedule, what's the best slot, this car go to that area. So that's how valuable it is. The data can be soaked. But this is only one camera. And we can choose this area to be our target and collect those images and provide some service. But even multiple, you have a lot of other sensors, you'll be in trouble.
Right.
So look at this. Those are sensors of different natures, okay? And you can group them and say, okay, this is the target I want to analyze. So when you select that one, it tells you, okay, this is actually a camera from some manufacturer. Every node has its own life, its data, its function. Because remember, our fingertips is going to act. When we collect information, here's the mosquito, and then my brain tells me to grab it, right? So they're action, they're actuators, not only sensors. In a city, there are actuators and sensors along the city, and we can do the best to move. So when we send something, and we need the nature, and after the plug and play, we know everything about the device. However, when we select those devices, those multiple devices to be our target, this is target, we can see how many information we have. This is just a camera. Camera, they are locations, their data, and there are different cameras, different builds, different functions. They do capture format, focusing range, frames per second. They have different features. They can do different things. So the combination is infinite. So if there's no way we can actually find a good business model if there's no help with big data, no algorithm. So we're looking for an algorithm to help us to to generate a business model, original heuristic business model. We need artificial intelligence to help us do that. Just like Albert said, optimization. We need an optimized way to optimize those information, the 1,000 link search returned by Google, to be a reasonable, manageable data. So that's why the complexity has to be reduced. Okay, that's what we're looking for. So in this paper, we use very simple model, compressed sensing or some reduction, the basic thing to do that. And further down the road, we're looking for a best way, because we do have data center, we do have those fingers collect data altogether. And we try to use the iStack, the INESA Smart City operating system, to help to build an intelligent way to suggest business model, so that we can incubate a lot of business working with government altogether to push the smart city service and in a sustainable way and also lucrative. Okay. So the data I've been analyzed and going to the data center and the going to the across the actual area across service layer and to provide such a service. Okay. So that's what we do here with gesture recognition, with dimensionality reductions, and we do some sparse transform and all that stuff to help us do that. And this is just a starting point. So this is our great opportunity, actually, to move on and to have this happen in the near future. And so I'll skip this magnetic part here. And so I use one example to conclude the analysis. We're basically in a small city. If you consider all those three lights, they are actual cameras in the light, and consider their vessels of human body everywhere. This is infrastructure. With that light, with different sensors on that, we can provide multiple services. That's what exactly we're doing. But we do need a better way to figure out what is the best business algorithm provided to make this happen. Okay. So that concludes my work, my report on the first part on the INESA iStack operating system. In the next part, actually, I talk about continue about the cities. You know, I've been working for Professor Lee for a long time. We worked together in Los Angeles City, and then later on working in San Jose. And we, you know, and Professor and myself, we work in, we look at different companies in San Jose. And I have a transfer from Cisco, from US Cisco, and transferred to Shanghai with Matt here. And with the Matt in Beijing, I think this is a very picture that we see. To the guy in the middle, Dr. Zhang. It's holding my daughter, Julia, sitting back there with my wife. You know, this picture shows a lot. You know, it's not only, you know, we just not only an advisor. Okay, this is a whole family thing. So, Professor and myself, we met in Beijing, different cities, and his students, right, which is my 10 seniors, we work in NDRC projects all together, and we work in Central NDRC project all together. And that's what I'm saying here. Okay? We have a lot of projects. But there is a mainstream to support the project. It's a family. It's a doctor, it's a family. The research family is not only talking about research, it's a relation that I benefit a lot. I really appreciate Dr. Lee. You know, the reason I'm standing here from the day one that I got a job in Pacific Bell. Well, actually, in day one that I got I can get a screening exam. You know, screening exam in USC, you have to get a master first, and then you get into admitted to the PhD degree program, and then you're advised to science, okay, you go take that. I don't have that. I just took Dr. Lee's class. I say, Professor, you know, I feel like to take the screen. I don't have a master's degree at all. I just came to the US a couple months. I need some of the scientists so that I can take the screening exam. And Professor looked at me, okay, sign it. And I pass it, I become a student. Okay, this is trust, this is faith. And this is the trust actually carry on all of, like, generation by generation. Like the trust that Lee and I built because of Dr. Lee. We trust each other. So this is a very, very inheritance, and I like to have that happen and seeing that happen all the time, generation by generation. A lot of work we collaborate all together. The IDRC is just a research thing. It's just it's a part of it. But the relation, the family relationship, and the influence that we learn from Dr. Lee, that how to think, how to organize things, how to do things, how to be a human being, that's the most important thing. I think that will essence for our future success. And look at this picture here. And I did a lot of things that reminds me, the Ling and I, we work together. And also this picture, there are pros and cons, okay? Not the family thing is not always good, okay? Because in China, in the different cities, even professor is not there, there's still influence. I was about to acquire a company in Hangzhou because of, I'm having the technology. I can say yes or no. And so the company shows up, okay, just come, they ask this much, okay, take a look. Okay, Dr. Lee's picture is there, and this is his student's company. Okay, so without a further thinking, say, okay, that's my proposal. And the people, financial guys, come with me together. It says, okay, this is probably an interest conflict. Okay, probably you know, it's you out of this board, so I can't actually vote yes. So it's still pending at this time. But next time I'll learn. I'll learn. When I see Dr. Lee's picture in some companies, I'll take a break and pretending that I have the cell phone and I'll go out and then come back to see what happened. So that I can make the right choice. I trust. You know, every people come from, inherited and extended from this research center from Dr. Lee. I trust. I know they can do a good job. Okay. Thank you very much.
Oh, by the way, is there any questions for Gary's technical talk? Yeah. All right. Thanks, Gary, again. I think your good word is really works, and I'm preparing for your good word last forever, and we're going to pass the